हेलो वेलकम अगेन, वी आर सॉल्विंग गेट एक्सी फ्लूड मैकेनिक्स पेपर ऑफ ईयर 2021। क्वेश्चन नंबर 17 इज ए लार्ज पंप इज टू डिलीवर ऑयल एट एन एवरेज वेलोसिटी ऑफ 1.5 मीटर पर सेकेंड। द पंप हैज़ एन इंपेलर डायमीटर डी ऑफ 40 सेंटीमीटर एंड द प्रेशर राइज अक्रॉस द पंप इज 400 kPa। To design this pump, a lab scale model pump with an impeller diameter of 4 cm is to be used with water as fluid. The viscosity of the oil is 100 times that of water and density of oil and water and density of oil and water are identical. A complete geometric similarity is maintained between model and prototype. If the pressure rise is a function of V, D, rho and mu, the pressure rise in kPa up to one decimal place across the model pump is. So applying the Reynolds model of creating Reynolds number of this prototype and model, so rho V D divided by mu of prototype will be equal to rho V D of mu divided by mu of model. So the density of this both density of fluid flowing through prototype and model is same, and viscosity is of prototype is 100 times that of viscosity of fluid flowing through model. Okay, and velocity of velocity in prototype is 1.5 meter per second. Okay, so V is 1.5 and diameter is your 40 centimeter. Okay, so this is your 40 centimeter and this ratio is your 100. Okay, so okay, this ratio is 100 and diameter of model is 4 centimeters. So we can find out velocity of velocity in model, velocity of fluid in model, that is 0.15 meter per second. Okay, now pressure is we know that pressure is directly proportional to rho L square V square, that is 4 divided by area, that is also indicative of force, that L square is because the indicative of area. So dimension, equating the dimension, this is rho L square V square is your force and this is your L square. So pressure is the function of as it is given as pressure is a function of V, D, L and rho. Okay, and D is your nothing but L. Okay, so L L cancel out. So no, pressure is the function of this rho and V square. Okay, so pressure ratio is for prototype it is rho P Vp square and for model it is rho and Vm square. Okay, rho P and rho are equal. Okay. So this is your this ratio is 400 by P. Okay, this ratio is your 400 by P, and this ratio is your 1.5. This ratio is your prototype. Prototype has a velocity 40. Okay, sorry, prototype has velocity 1.5, and model has velocity 0.15. So Pm is your 4 P. So answer is 4 kPa. Next, the water density 10^3 kilogram per meter cube enters steadily into a horizontal pipe vent, which is part of a larger piping system as shown in figure. The volumetric flow rate of water is 0.1 meter cube per second. The gauge pressure at the inlet is 500 kPa, while the exit is open to atmosphere. The x component of the force on the spout is fx. The absolute value of fx in kilonewton up to one decimal place. So this is with the system given. Then this area is your, here this area is 200 centimeter square. This area is 100 centimeter square. And the volumetric flow rate is given as 0.1 meter cube per second. And the gauge pressure at inlet is 500 MPa and here there is atmosphere pressure. So we can say the difference of pressure between these two is 500 because this is a gauge pressure. Total pressure is 1500. Here the total pressure will be here 500 plus atmosphere pressure. Here only the atmosphere pressure. So difference is here 500. Okay. So we can find out velocity at 1 minute. We can find out velocity at 2 because discharge is given. Volumetric rate is given. So volumetric rate is 0.1 divided by area. Okay. So velocity at 1 minute will be 5 meter per second. And similarly, the velocity at 2 will also be because here area is less, so velocity at 2 will be 10 meter per second. Okay. But this velocity is in this direction. Okay. And this is in opposite direction. The change in momentum will be rho av v1 minus v2 because v2 is opposite. So we take it minus. So and rho av is your av is your 0.1 and rho is 1000. So v1 minus v2 is your 5 plus 10 because 10 is in opposite direction. So it will be force due to change in momentum will be 1800 newton. But and the force due to pressure, force due to pressure is your fx 1 into a1. Okay. Because only the pressure is more in this area. Okay. So the force will be your 500 into 1000 into 200 into changing into meters square. Okay. So that will be 10,000. So we will multiply the area, this area with the gauge pressure because pressure is more here. Okay. And less here. Okay. And atmospheric here. Okay. So total force will be summation of these two momentum force plus the inertia force, that is 11,500 newton over 11.5 square meter. Okay. Next, air of density 0.5 kilogram per meter cube enters horizontally into a jet engine at a steady speed of 200 meter per second through an inlet area of 1 meter square. Upon entering the engine, the air passes through the combustion chamber and the exhaust fans exit the jet engine horizontally at a constant speed of 700 meter per second. The fuel mass flow rate added in the combustion chamber is negligible compared to the air mass flow rate. Also neglect the pressure difference between the inlet air and exhaust. The absolute value of horizontal force in kilonewton up to 1 decimal place on the jet engine is. So this is your combustion chamber. Here the air is entering at 200 meter per second. Air is leaving at 700 meter per second. Okay. And this and density of air is 0.5. Okay. And velocity is and inlet area is 1 meter square. Okay, so this area is 1 meter square. So mass entering is rho av. So 1 is your area, 0.5 is density, and v is your velocity. Okay, so this will be 100 kilogram per second. And horizontal force will be mass per second into changing velocity, and velocity changing from 200 to 700. So that is your mass flow rate, and then velocity change. So that is 50,000 newton or 50 kilonewton.